Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Forma Therapy. This is the Culture Study. I'm the channel's video producer and your host. You can call me PD. And today we are checking out Agyon, aka Dark Dream by Elast. Thank you, everyone, who put this on my radar. I know we're a bit late to it, but I didn't realize they had to come back up until like a week ago. So thank you, everyone, who let us know. Elast, while they are a smaller group, I have been fairly impressed with everything they've been putting out. Something you guys might have missed because we reacted to it on our Patreon because this wasn't a comeback title track. I believe it was like a B-side music video, but they had a music video for one of their songs called Dangerous. And that one definitely sold me on them. Dangerous was fantastic. It was phenomenal. That reaction might be lost in the ether as well. But that definitely bought a lot of brownie points for me. And I was really, really looking forward to their comeback. And then, of course, we're late. But, you know, better late than never. Before we get into Agyon, as I mentioned, we do bonus reactions over on our Patreon. If you guys want to check that out, you can go visit us. If not, that's completely fine. Let's just get into the video. This is Agyon, aka Dark Dream by Elast, and this is your form of therapy. Wow. Given what we've heard from Elast, I can't even tell if that's a part of the actual song or if that was just an intro for the video. Oh, wow. The way they just immediately slipped into this. Wow, they have such a consistent musical style. Oh. Oh man, this guy is beautiful. Oh, I love his nose. Oh, wow, Jesus. Holy moly, what the f- They were keeping it to relatively simple setups up until right then. All right, that this must be the chorus. Also, those outfits are gorgeous. Wow. Okay, so Alas, Dark Dream keeps in line with everything we've heard so far from their previous titles as well. Alas's greatest strength being that they are one of the few groups, if not maybe the only group, doing like genuinely older style of Korean pop music. Especially Alas, not only is like the songwriting style a little bit dated, and I don't mean dated in an insulting way. I think it's very refreshing. But also, their style is just so cinematic. It feels more like a musical journey rather than a pop song. I think that's what I like the most about Dark Dream. I think Dark Dream also a little bit more than the other title tracks, and this might sound like this is a downside, but this is an upside for me, is that I have no idea what's going on in this song. As in, like, I'm like, where does the verse begin and, like, the chorus start and the bridge end? It's like, it's all one giant kind of musical journey. And, you know, those types of songs are very rare where they, especially for me as well, where it kind of lets you turn your brain off and just, like, let it take you. Let the song take you. For example, if we compare it directly to Dangerous, Dangerous is definitely a much more conventional narrative in terms of the structure of that song. Like, you know what the pre-chorus is. You know what the chorus is. It's a lot more obvious like that, even though even Dangerous is also a very, like, retro style of K-pop. It's not so much that this construction style is an older style. No, like, pop songs have a pretty simple layout, you know? So Dark Dream actually doesn't subscribe to that layout, even more so than I think their other titles. I would actually like to also listen to it again. Like, it says this was, like, 350, but was that from the get-go? Let's go ahead and watch from the beginning. Wow. So it might have been from the get-go. That's a long song. So it's like nearly a 4-minute song. That's very rare for a title track. Wow. Ooh. They have such beautiful vocalists too. So was that the core? So they hadn't maybe perhaps the construction of this was an intro, and then maybe that was the chorus. You know how some songs they play the chorus at the top of the song, and then they get into the first verse. Maybe that's what the case of this is. Hold on, I'm gonna have to actually go back and listen to that part again. It's like the intro, and then right here. Alright, I gotta remember that. So I feel like this is the... Ooh. The song also has like a sexy push and pull nature to it. And I love that the construction of the song also leans into that as well. The instrumental, like the way it slows down, those like momentary pauses, those bump, brow, and then like when you hear like the swell of like the instruments, in this case, like the droning sounds, like all of a sudden it feels like a surge of emotions, you know, a surge of passion, and especially like that guitar we just heard, like right there. It really adds into kind of like the yearning and the sexiness of the lyrics as well. That's my favorite part right there. That the top line right there, the na 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 na. It seems like it does not belong in this song, which is exactly why I like it. It stands out so much because of it. It sounds like the kind of top line you'd hear on, I don't know, maybe a hip-hop song, a rap song, maybe a K-pop song, maybe like a different pop song. But for here, like everything up until this point that we've been listening to definitely sounds like the more epic, sexy, beautiful singing that we've heard. But then here he brings in a very interesting melody. Oh. Like, what portion is this? So, like, what was that? Was that the chorus? The na 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 na. So then, like, if we're assuming that, if we're going off the assumption that that was the chorus, what, this is maybe the post-chorus or the second verse? Okay, this definitely feels more like a second verse. Also, like, what is that, like, velvet velour that they're wearing? It's so beautiful. Yeah, this definitely feels more like the chorus. They just kind of go into it without like your usual typical buildup. Oh, I like that part. Oh. I really don't know what to make of this song. Oh, this guy is so beautiful. I love his facial structure. Okay, so maybe the confusion comes from, like, maybe it's a two-part chorus and it's like a really long chorus. I don't know. Like, we're already at 2:37 and that's when you should be ramping towards the end of the song, but we still have like a minute 30 left in this song. That's where, like, I'm so confused. Like, it definitely doesn't follow conventional narratives. Okay, this definitely, I'm certain, this is definitely the chorus. Alright, this is more so the bridge. Alright. God, I love this guy. And this guy, damn. Damn, what? Four rappers? Three? My God. So this is also something I wanted to comment on. The music video kept it rather simple. I wouldn't say it was a low budget music video up until this point, but you know, they were being a little bit tight with their budget. But it was still a beautiful music video nonetheless. They had a lot of beautiful sets. They were going for like the minimalist look, had an elegant look to it. The contrast between like the minimal white set mixed with like the black, infinite black void backdrop with like the red strings, that really worked together. But it also looks like they were kind of saving a lot of that budget for the kind of this whole set piece at the end, which doesn't come in until like the last 30 seconds of the video, but it has a lot of impact, right? It really feels like the music video is taking you on a journey, and the last 30 seconds really truly feel epic because of it. I really think they were really smart to orchestrate their budget in that way. Oh, I gotta see like a dance video for this. Whoa, I wanna see that jump in like a fuller shot. You know, the song is called Dark Dream. I wonder if the kind of confusing nature of the structure of the song is intentional or perhaps a happy byproduct of just, you know, having these brilliant songwriters. But it feels a little lost. But it's, like I said, it's definitely purposeful. Like, it's messy, but it's messy on purpose. Like, you don't know where you are. It's kind of like when you're dreaming or you're having a nightmare and, you know, there's no beginning, there's no middle, there's no end, you know? Like, there's no beginning to a dream, right? You're just suddenly in the middle of a dream. It's kind of how that feels. You feel like you're just thrown into a song and you're kind of lost, like, trying to figure your way out, but it all feels intentional with the song. All right, Alas, Dark Dream. As confusing and as trippy as it is, it might be some of the finest, most interesting works of just arrangement and composing I have heard in just recent years. And Alast is definitely the only group doing it exactly the way they are. There are very few groups that can actually say they do it like that, but Alast, they truly are doing it like no other. There's a lot of unique groups in K-pop, which is a fantastic thing. But even some unique groups kind of overlap. There's some groups that like do an older retro style of K-pop and stuff like that. But Alast, it mixes having kind of like a more older style of songwriting style, which they've kept consistent throughout their title tracks, which is weird. And I've only heard one B-side now, Dangerous, but because of this, this makes me want to listen to their entire discography now. The fact that this doesn't feel like a gimmick, this feels like a much more purposeful push from their A&R. You know, that doesn't always happen. Sometimes they do it for like the debut, maybe like a comeback or two, and then if it's not working out, they're like, all right, let's just go with like the conventional norm. But with the last keeping this up, I'm like, oh, okay, so this isn't just like a gimmick that they're trying to do. This is really a part of the group's sound, and I love groups and companies that carefully manage their artist's sound more so than their image. So I would actually like to check out all of Alast's discography. I'm very curious to see what their B-sides are going to sound like. But yeah, Agyeon, Dark Dream by Alast. I think this is their best title track yet. I think this is their best. I think the packaging for it is also, and by the packaging, I mean conceptually, the outfits, the music video, all of that is also, it's perfect. I think this is perhaps also their most memorable title track to date as well. Admittedly, this might be the music video that has turned me into an Alast fan, or someone who is genuinely going to get into Alast, because admittedly, I don't really remember a lot of the other Alast title tracks. I have like vague, like almost like kind of like a dream. I have like vague, vivid images and moments from these music videos, but I largely don't remember the sound of this. The sound of the song, but this also helps in that because their sound is so iconic, iconic's not the right word, but because it's so distinct and literally no other group is doing it like their title tracks, I still have a vague notion and understanding of what their other title tracks were. But in the other side, like on the flip side, Dangerous, I remember pretty well. Like Dangerous, na 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 na, like, it's just like Dangerous is that catchy, you know, and because Alast's title tracks fall into the typical K-pop norms, perhaps that's why I don't remember it as much, because it doesn't do the typical catchy thing. But I think Dark Dream, especially having like that one portion in the middle that I was just talking about, I mentioned as my favorite part. Yeah, this part. Like, maybe perhaps that part is what helps make this song a lot more memorable for me as well. But I'm definitely going to be doing a deep dive into Alas soon. If you guys want to check that out, you can visit our Patreon. It's probably where we're going to wind up doing it. But guys, thank you for checking out our reaction and review of Alas Dream. You know, there's not that many people who request Alas, but the people who do seem to be really, really passionate. And honestly, their music makes me understand why you're so passionate. The music is truly incredible. It almost feels like if you took like an orchestra or like a symphony and then they made these title tracks. They're so artful and they have such a classic sound to it. And not just like, oh, classic mixed with like modern sounds. No, it just literally feels like a classic sound. So that's really, really cool. And feels like it's a treat every time I react to Alas. So I think it's about time that... I think this is like the third Alas title track I'm checking out. And it's... For me, again, it's always about the third. So, yeah, I'm going to be getting more into them. If you guys want to check that out with us, you can visit us over on our Patreon. We do listening parties over there. We do bonus reactions to, like, variety shows, reality, survival reactions. We're checking out K-dramas, especially this month. We're doing a lot of horror-themed content, like Squid Game, Sweet Home, Strangers from Hell. So if you guys want to check that out with us, you can visit our Patreon. If you don't want to support us monetarily, it's completely fine. You know, you can support us for free by just hitting the like button down below. Consider subscribing. We're going to have the button for you right here. Check out our other videos over here, and we'll see you next time. Bye.